Thank you. I'm spiritually discerned. Thank you, Lord, for the blood that ran down. But we realize that the blood has healing. We realize that in the blood there's deliverance. But most of all, there's forgiveness. Thank you, Lord, for the purchase. Thank you for the purchase. Thank you for the purchase. Thank you for the purchase. But if you don't go by the cross, you're wasting your time. If you don't talk about the blood that ran down, you might as well have a seat. You're wasting your time. The man gave up his seat in glory. None of us deserved it. Deserved, but he gave up his seat. Can't you see him taking off his robe and saying, "Send me, send me."
Aren't you glad that we serve a God that's willing to pay with everything?
even his life. Many of us as shoppers, amen, when we are purchasing things, we spend time in the newspaper, the magazines, even on our devices looking for coupons, looking to save money, looking to buy cheap. And many of us will not buy unless the price is right. Y'all know I'm right. Y'all sit around the house and wait on a sale before you go and purchase what you're looking for. Regardless of what it is, even if you're looking for a car, you're going to wait. They go down at the end of the month. We're going to wait until we hear the deals come out on the radio. Then we'll go purchase. Many of us buy cheap to save money. But in the long run, it cost us more to buy cheap if we would have went ahead and just spend some money on quality.
Amen.
Aren't you glad we serve a God that recognizes quality?
Amen.
He's not afraid to pay the cost. He didn't sit around in heaven waiting on a deal, did he?
No, he didn't.
He said, I'm going now. And I'm going to pay the cost. We was bought with a price. Remember, the Bible does say salvation is free. But I need to let you know that it's not cheap. There's a cost when it comes to salvation. The Bible says free, but there is a price to pay. So let me make this thing make sense to you. When we talk about price versus cost, when we'll talk about being bought with a price, let me give you some earthly examples. I can't tell you what a price of cigarettes costs, but I know it's somewhere in the $5 and $6 range. But if you think about the price of a pack of cigarettes and versus the cost of lung cancer. Are you willing to pay the cost? What about the price of a can of beer or alcohol? I don't know what it costs you. I don't know what the price is, but the cost of a head-on accident. DUI. The cost of liver disease. For that price, that $5 price. The cost. I'm trying to make it make sense to you. Let me get a little real with you. The price of having some fun versus the cost of deadly diseases. You may as well recognize, because it's out there. There's a cost. Are you willing to pay the cost? The price of crack cocaine versus losing everything. Losing your family, losing your house. Everything that you worked over the price of $25. The cost is high. What I'm trying to say, brothers and sisters, we serve a God that's willing to pay the high cost for someone like you and I that does not deserve it. He's willing to pay the cost. And I want you to know that it is through the blood and only through the blood that the price is paid. Through the blood. Nothing else. The song just said the blood, the blood, the blood. And it's only through his blood that the price is paid. It's only through the blood of Christ and only through the blood that we are redeemed. Nothing else washes away our sin but the blood of Jesus. I was taught coming up, sitting under Reverend Miller, he said, when you preach and when you teach, if you don't go by the cross, he said, you have wasted your time. If you don't preach the blood of Jesus, if you don't preach that he lived, he died, you have not preached. Every now and then when you're teaching, you ought to go by the cross. Every now and then you ought to talk about the blood. If you haven't teached. you haven't preached. We can sit up here and preach and teach 365 days of the year. But if you don't talk about the blood, you may as well take a seat. Because you haven't done anything. We got to talk about the price that was shed on Calvary. We got to talk about his shed blood that ran down. We set aside today to remember. This is communion. To remember the blood that was shed. And when we consider the cost, when we consider, amen, that he was sold out, we consider that he was spit on. When we consider he was jailed and beaten, when we consider that he was nailed and hung, we ought to remember this day every day. We shouldn't set aside a time to remember the blood once a month. We ought to talk about the blood of Jesus every day. Conversation, the blood of Jesus ought to come up somewhere.
Yeah, that's right. Amen.
He have done too much.
Yes,
paid with his life.
Yeah.
And we only set aside one day out the month to remember what he's done. We ought to be able to do it 7 days a week. I don't care how well versed you are. You can talk from Genesis to Revelation. You can quote it probatum, or however you say that. But if you don't talk about the blood, and if you do not believe it, then you have wasted your time. I don't know about you, but I'm glad that I serve a God who had a plan, and already planned to come down and purchase me. Not only that, but I'm glad I serve a God who had the funds to purchase me. And he purchased me with his life. I didn't deserve it. There's a price versus cost. I didn't deserve it, but he did it anyway. Don't you know, brothers and sisters, before he redeemed us, amen, we was all held captive. Amen, by Satan's sins. These are the same sins that enslaves us.
Yeah.
All the way from the days of Adam.
Yeah.
For we was born in sin.
Yes.
We inherited from Adam.
Yeah.
And it's only through the blood of Christ.
Yes.
That we are redeemed.
Yes.
And washed free of our sins.
Yes.
Even in the Bible days, whenever a slave was bound and enslaved, if you had the right amount of money, amen, they could be set free. And when you look at 2017, regardless of what you've done, if you can buy the right lawyer, you won't have to spend time, amen, in man's jail. Can I get a witness? But I need to let you know this afternoon that the only thing that can free you from sin is the blood of Jesus. It is the blood of Jesus, amen, that can only free you, amen, from the sins that have been committed. He paid the price, amen, and he paid the ransom. And he paid it in full.
Yes, he did.
Through his blood.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
It is only the blood of Jesus that can set us free, amen, from our sins. It's only the blood of Jesus, amen, that can redeem us, amen, and forgive us for all the wrong that has been committed. And what I like about being washed under the blood, the Bible says once he forgive us, can I get a witness? He toss it in the sea, amen, of forgetfulness. Can I get a witness? If that's not good enough for you, amen, and he cast it as far as the east, amen, from the west. Can I get a witness? I'm going to close, but I'd like to tell you a story. Can I get a witness? There was a lady, amen, that lied on her sick bed. Can I get a witness? The preacher said, I'm going by. Amen, I got to see her. Can I get a witness? Ain't God all right? He made it by the seated lady. And he took her by the hand. Can I get a witness? He told her, I came by. I need to forgive you for your sins. Can I get a witness? She opened up her eyes. Can I get a witness and let me see your hands? Ain't God all right? She told him, amen, that the only one that can forgive me of my sin, there ought to be holes in your hand. Can I get a witness? She told the preacher, I'm going to give you another chance. Come close to me. Ain't God all right? Put my hand on your side. Can I get a witness? I want to feel the hole in your side. Ain't God all right? She told the preacher, the only man that can forgive me of my sin got a hole in his side. Can I get a witness? She told him, I'm gonna give you one more chance. Ain't God all right? She asked the question, have you ever died? Ain't God all right? Have you ever died? Can I get a witness? Have you ever died? Have you ever been buried? Ain't God all right? She asked the question, did you lay there part of three long days? Ain't God all right? She asked the preacher, she said, did you get up? Did you get up on that first day morning? Ain't God all right? With all power. And they whipped him. Ain't God all right? They put a crown of thorns on his head. Ain't God all right? She asked the question, have you ever carried a cross up on a hill called Calvary? Ain't God all right? Jesus went up on a hill called Calvary. Ain't God all right? Ain't God all right? Nailed his hand, riveted his feet. Ain't God all right? Raised him up on an old rugged cross. Ain't God all right? Ain't he all right? only through Christ that man who shed his blood, the man who had a plan. He said, I got a plan. Nothing else will set him free but me. He told his father, I'm going to leave my heavenly home. No, none of them deserve it. None of them deserve it. But I'm God. And I'm going down. I'm going to purchase them with my blood. We are bought with a price. Get under the blood of Jesus. Will you come? Will you come right now? If you want to get under the blood, you want to give him your life today. It's only the blood of Christ. Only through the blood of Christ. You can give me your hand, but I want you to come give God your heart today. blood of Jesus. It's only about the blood of Jesus. Time has been set aside now that we remember what took place on Calvary. Let us pray. Lord Father, we thank you, Lord, for what is a bird, what hearts are filled. We thank you, Lord, for your word that has gone forward. And Father, we thank you for what you've done on Calvary, what you did on Calvary. We thank you, Lord, that you paid the ransom with your life, you shed your blood. Father, we pray now that you bless this communion. We pray, Lord, that you turn it from a physical into a spiritual. We pray, Lord, that we don't bring damnation upon our sins. Father, we pray now that you bless the wine, we bless the bread, that it represents your blood and your broken body. Bless those that will partake of it. In Jesus' name we pray and thank you.
Yeah.
everyone been served? Amen. It's about the blood. Those 12, they went with Jesus. They traveled with Jesus. They witnessed his miracles. They witnessed him raising the dead. They witnessed him making lame walk. But when he took them to the upper room, they just couldn't understand. What are you talking about, man? When are you going to leave us? Where are you going? Then you're talking about getting up. They just did not understand. But we got the advantage. We've heard about it. We read about it. We know what he had done. Jesus, at that supper, he took the bread. He broke it and blessed it and said, "This represents my broken body." Amen. He said, "Take ye, eat all of it." Likewise, he took the cup. "This blood, this wine represents my shed blood." Amen. He said, "Take ye, drink all of it." Amen. Amen. Hold the blood.